Welcome to Core Finance. It gives me great pleasure, as always, to introduce Mr. Tim Harrison. He's the head of wealth management at Linear Investments. Morning to you, young Tim.
Good morning.
Right, let's kick off with the headlines this morning. The FOMC's minutes stated that many policymakers felt another rate increase was likely. Now, I read we were talking about a 90% probability. I think it's pulled back to about 88%. This is a done deal, right?
One would have suggested so. However, you've obviously got tomorrow, you've got the retail and CPI figures in the US, which again is another nugget to look out for to see how quickly and by how many rate rises we may see next year, potentially. That being said, I am very, very cautious on the rhetoric coming out because I don't think the US is as firm as people like to believe. Inflation is still very, very low. They need inflation to really justify a continual sustained rate rise schedule in the US. And at the moment, there are a few people saying yes, but there are a couple who are saying nothing too quick too soon.
Understood. Let's move on to FTSE One to Watch, Ferguson,
once known as Wolseley. In terms of the company, they've changed the name recently to align themselves with their US business, which was called or is called Ferguson. Obviously, building supplies, plumbing supplies, etc., looking at the growth of the general housing market over here and in the US. It's a company whose shares are near or at all-time highs. It's a level that they've been at a number of times before over the last couple of years, but having navigated through the market downturn, these sorts of companies, in my opinion, are the ones that you want to be having as part of a core portfolio.
Understood. High beta play as well. We used to
if
trade
you believe that,
a lot.
If you believe that the world is going to continue to improve, that is.
Understood. Let's talk about AIM One to Watch. AO.com, what are they doing?
AO World, so they're your white goods specialists. Now, they IPO'd a couple of years ago, just shy of
£3.
This
has been a disaster, hasn't it?
Precisely that. They're trading around about £1.10 at the moment, £1.12. So the shares have come from £3 when they IPO'd two, 3 years ago, down to here. You know, I'm suggesting, in my opinion, these sorts of companies, where they are on their proverbial, they're maybe worth having a nibble at. With all the bad news that's happened with regards to the company and their expansion, etc., it's always a bit of bottom fishing, so to speak.
Understood. In terms of currencies, the Great British Pound against the US dollar, 132.53, and the Euro Great British Pound cross 89.52. Obviously, the FTSE above 7,500 last week on the weakness of the Great British Pound. Obviously, we potentially got an interest rate hike in the UK at the moment. So is this about British Pound strength or dollar weakness or vice versa?
I think it's a bit of both. As I say, I mean, my personal opinion, and as I've highlighted on here numerous times, is Britain is in pretty decent health. The US, I think, is a little bit smoke and mirrors. And thus, I think it is a case of the two batting heads or butting heads together. In my view, obviously, we are potentially going to see a rate rise in the UK simply because the core inflation data, etc., is starting to pick up. So I can see sterling strengthening, but it depends on what we see from the US. And with regards to rate rises, if we do see rate rises, then you could see further dollar strength.
Do you think British Pound will be basically going up on the back of an interest rate hike in November, if you were a betting man? That you're not?
I'm not a betting man.
Okay.
Look, I think at the moment, the propensity for sterling to range between 130 and 136 is my personal
view. That's the range. Yep.
I can't see it breaking down unless the UK really starts to contract and the US really starts to fire on all cylinders.
Understood. Let's go on to broker upgrades, downgrades. The company Foxtons today, Berenberg, a downgrade, price target 50 pence.
Foxtons are obviously London-centric. They are probably the most publicised London-centric property estate agent, if you like. It's an interesting downgrade because it's quite a significant value below where their share price is right now. I mean, they've been trading around about the 65 to 67 level for quite some time. It's a significant decrease from where we are currently trading. Again, is suggesting that they are seeing a slowdown in volume of sales agreed and property coming to the market. There's plenty on the market, but it's just not shifting. So these sorts of companies where they are reliant on, foreign money and money coming into London, these sorts of companies are potentially going to struggle.
Okay, seller for choice by the sounds of it. Right, let's go on to the core number, 1.5 billion. What number is that?
So that's the record inflows into Hargreaves Lansdown over recent times. Now, funnily enough, they attributed a large portion of that, or speculators attributed a large portion of that due to Barclays changing their platform to their smart platform. People getting fed up with it and transferring away. That being said, as I highlighted yesterday, you know, the Aberdeen Standard Life, the asset managers, these sorts of companies are potentially ones to look out for, because everyone is putting money into the markets, because we are at all-time highs there or thereabouts. The appetite for investment is there, and the steady eddy asset managers are the ones that are benefiting.
Okay, let's wrap up with the economic calendar today. Anything there to sort of move the markets in any shape or form? All about central bankers again, right?
ECB with Draghi, I'd suggest. And also, if you are an oil trader or commodities player, I suppose the EIA figures later on in the day. But I think all eyes will be on Draghi and the strength of the Eurozone, simply because that will then give us the potentially the opportunity for the UK to follow suit or to make formative steps with reference to a rate rise or not.
Finally, we've got a guest on today suggesting a stock market crash over this weekend. As a portfolio manager, are you having good night's rest at the moment?
Well, look, I mean, as I've always highlighted, I'm always cautious of what could happen. It's all well and good saying the Dow's at record highs, the FTSE's at 7.5, pushing towards 7.6, everything's hunky-dory. But there is obviously an appetite for the downside here because we are at extreme levels. I've always said be careful. I wouldn't say we're due a crash because there are so many different mechanisms in the market than there have been, you know, 10, 15 years ago, where it's just really human-based. Now you've got the algorithms, etc., picking up fundamental value rather than noise. So I can't see a crash, but I have suggested to my clients be cautious of a gradual decline.
Tim, wise words as always. Thank you very much indeed.